Hello everyone. Welcome to the second webinar of our webinar series on WSO2 updates. I'm Vimukti Pereira and I have my colleague Savindu Dias with me here today. Welcome Savi. We are from the installation experience team here at WSO2. We focus on installing WSO2 products on various platforms such as Docker, Vagrant, AWS, Kubernetes, etc. and developing and maintaining configuration management resources such as Puppet and Ansible. Also, we focus on delivering updates to WSO2 product as well. Our topic for today is delivering continuous updates to environments managed by Puppet. So moving on to the discussion points, in today's webinar, we are going to talk about why you should use Puppet in your environment. And then we will give you a brief introduction to the Puppet resources for WSO2 products. Next, we will talk about how the in-place updates tool is used in delivering updates continuously to the environments managed by Puppet, followed by a demonstration on how to use our Puppet resources in your environment, and then run the in-place update tool alongside with it to deliver updates. So why Puppet? To those who are not familiar with Puppet, I will give you a brief introduction on Puppet. Puppet is one of the most commonly used configuration management tools among Chef, Ansible, etc. And it is used in configuring and managing servers. Puppet is written by Ruby. It has its own domain-specific language for creating and managing modules. The basic version of Puppet, which is called Open Source Puppet, is available through Puppet's website. You can just visit the website and download it from there. Puppet also has an enterprise version where you need to pay to use it. Okay, Puppet has a master agent architecture. Puppet agent is a daemon that runs on the client server. All the clients who are to be managed should have Puppet agent installed on them. Puppet master should have all the modules in it, and it is the centralized place to manage the infrastructure. The connection between the Puppet agent and the Puppet master is made in a secure encrypted channel using SSL. Puppet has a full module architecture. So as I mentioned before, all the Puppet modules are available in the Puppet master. The agent can select whatever the module it needs to run to achieve the desired state. In the demonstration, you will see how it happens. So let's see why you should use Puppet in your environment. You can easily define infrastructure as code by using Puppet. That is, using Puppet modules, you can define the packages or tools you want to install, system configurations, create users and user groups with different permission levels, and so on. Puppet being a declarative language means that you are writing the code and you decide what the status of your server should be after running the code and what the server should not have. The program will decide what to do to achieve the target state of the server, and you do not have to worry about it. Pretty cool, right? When you define your system using code, it will help you minimize the risk of human errors. With automation, you can eliminate the manual work and deploy faster. Basically, using Puppet is a way more reliable than configuring your system manually. Puppet is capable of managing multiple servers at once. This can either be similar types of instances or different types of instances or a combination of both. Also, Puppet helps in automating all the system administration tasks. You can define a manifest that describes the desired end state of your systems, and Puppet takes care of making sure the system meets that desired end state. If a file is altered or deleted on the Puppet agent, it is replaced with an exact same copy. if a package is uninstalled somehow, it is reinstalled. So the system administrators can reduce the time spent on such repetitive tasks, ensuring consistent configuration across their infrastructure. Also, Puppet helps dynamic scaling. See, you need to increase the number of API Manager gateways in your deployment due to the increasing traffic. What you need to do is spawn up a new instance and configure Puppet agent in it to run the API Manager gateway module. It will work the same as all the other APM gateway nodes. Likewise, huge systems can be governed using a Puppet master with a well-written set of Puppet modules. Also, you can minimize the cost when expanding your business. Let me explain what that means. Say you have a small business, and based on the traffic you get, you only need two API Manager gateways in your deployment. If you configure the nodes manually without a configuration management tool like Puppet, as it is just two nodes, it won't be a big burden. But after a while, your business expands, and now you need, say, 10 API Manager gateways. Now you have to scale your infrastructure, and also you need a better way of managing the infrastructure, as it is not easy to manage 10 nodes manually. The cost of this is pretty high. But if you have used Puppet at the initial stage of your deployment, that is when you are with just two nodes of API Manager gateways, it is just a matter of adding a new node, or rather multiple nodes, to the deployment and configuring Puppet agent accordingly. Puppet will take care of everything else. So let's move on to Puppet resources for WSO2 products. We have Puppet resources for all the WSO2 products at the moment, which includes the WSO2 API Manager, Identity Server, Enterprise Integrator, and Stream Processor. When it comes to WSO2 solutions, there are Puppet resources for our Open Banking solution. But as you may know, our Open Banking solution is closed source. So the Puppet resources for Open Banking is available on request. But we are planning on making those Puppet resources public in the near future. All the resources are continuously updated and easy to use. Let's look into the features of Puppet resources provided by WSO2. WSO2 Puppet modules are written in a way that it would make it easier for anyone who uses them to construct a WSO2 recommended product deployment pattern easily. So these product patterns could either be a set of profiles or runtimes of a certain product, or a combination of several product profiles or product runtimes, or a combination of both. For example, you can use the Puppet modules for WSO2 API Manager and create a recommended API Manager deployment pattern, which might include two API Manager gateway nodes, two traffic manager nodes, one publisher node, two API Manager key manager nodes, one store node, and two API Manager analytics worker node. Also, you can combine Puppet modules for identity server with the Puppet modules for API Manager to create a solution recommended by WSO2, which may include two API Manager all-in-one nodes and two identity server nodes. So our Puppet resources are written in a way that it will enforce the best practices recommended by WSO2 and also by Puppet. That means our Puppet scripts contain best practices recommended by Puppet itself, the recommended system configurations to run a WSO2 product, and best practices recommended by WSO2 when configuring a WSO2 product. So it is very easy to use these modules, as we have documented everything you need to know about extending and customizing Puppet resources. If you are a Puppet 5 user, you may already know that there is a lack of documentation for Puppet 5. So we are happy to help with all the questions you have regarding our Puppet resources. You just need to open a support ticket if you have a WSO2 subscription, or you can contribute to our open source resources by creating an issue on GitHub. Also, you can create a free trial with WSO2, which will be valid for 15 days. The most important feature included in our Puppet resources is continuous update delivery. We use the in-place updates tool provided by WSO2 to enable this feature. If you attended our previous webinar on updating your WSO2 products, you know how in-place update tool works. But to whomever could not attend our previous webinar, I will give you a brief introduction to how the in-place update tool works. In-place update tool is the latest addition to the WSO2 update story. The tool is capable of identifying your product, identifying if there are relevant updates, downloading them, and applying them on top of your customized product. Let me say that again. The tool is capable of identifying your product, identifying if there are relevant updates based on the channel you have updated your product previously, downloading them, and applying them on top of your customized product. The tool is capable of merging updates on top of your customized text files, such as JSPs, JAGs, automatically. If there are any conflicts, the in-place update tool will list out the conflicts for you to resolve manually. Please note that a conflict is a very rare case. So in case if you come across a conflict, as I mentioned before, you need to resolve it manually and run the in-place update tool again. To see whether you have conflicts before running it actually on your product, you can use the dry run feature in the in-place update tool as well. The tool is also capable of reverting back to your previous state as it generates a backup before every run. You can find all the details about this in-place update tool under official WSO2 documentation, and we have given the link under resources at the end of this slide deck. Okay, back to continuously deliver updates through Puppet. So what we do is we use this feature in the in-place updates tool in our scripts to update the product before it gets shipped to the Puppet agents. Savidu will show you how we do it in the demonstration. So let's move on to the Puppet module architecture. So this is our Puppet module architecture. So here we have a common module, which is common to all the WSO2 product profile or runtime. We have init pp, we have a init pp, a params pp, and a service pp. In the init pp, what we do is we create system users, and then we install Java, and then copy or download the product packages. You can choose either to copy or to download the product package. In the params pp, we have the parameters which include system user information and the JDK information and any parameters common to all the product profiles or runtimes. In the service pp, what we do is we start the product profile or product runtime as a service. So in the profile module, we have whatever specific for each product profile or product runtime. There we have an init pp, a params pp, and a custom pp. In the params pp, we have profile specific parameters and the list of files which are templated. These files contain the configurations you need to do when you run WSO2 products in your environment. In the init pp, what we do is apply the list of templates. Apply the list of templates I mentioned previously, and if you need to copy certain files like certificates or tools like API manager, import export tool, you can add it here. So in case you need to delete a certain file, the code for that should be here as well. As I mentioned at the beginning of the webinar, you can easily extend and customize the Puppet resources provided by WSO2. So to do that, you can use the custom PP. So you can write any custom code specific to your system here. So that's all about architecture of WSO2 Puppet modules. So let's move on to delivering continuous updates. This diagram is to give you an understanding of how the updates are shipped to the environments managed by Puppet. As you can see, there are three environments: dev environment, staging environment, and production environment. All the environments are synced with the Puppet master. The update level of all the environment is update level X. To update the environments with the latest update, that is update level X plus 1, what you need to do is run a script provided by WSO2 Puppet resources. In this script, we use the in-place updates tool, as I mentioned before. By running the script, you can update your product to update level X plus 1. Then we can apply the configurations. And we can ship it to the environments as required. Okay, let's move on to the demonstration and see how easy it is to do all these things I have explained just now. Over to you, Savi.
All right. Thank you, Vimukti. So before we begin, let me do a quick recap of our Puppet module architecture. So you can find Puppet modules for all of our products on GitHub. So you can find it for API Manager, Identity Server, Enterprise Integrator, and Stream Processor. So if we take a look at the Puppet modules for something like, let's say, API Manager, you can see that we have separate modules for each and every individual profile. So we have a module for API Manager, Gateway, Key Manager, and so on. Also, you can see that we have a module for, we have a common module as Vimukti explained earlier. So actually in this demo, we will not be using API Manager. Instead, we will be using Identity Server, because unlike API Manager, it is a lot simpler in terms of the amount of modules it has. It only has this one module for Identity Server, but it also has modules for things such as for analytics, but we will not be going into that. So let's take a look at our distributed setup. So as you can see on the right, we have the Puppet master. And on the left, in the light theme, what you have is the Puppet agent. So if you want to see if, so we have already set up the Puppet master and agent. So if you, you can see that Puppet master is running here and the agent is running here. Also, keep in mind that you can have as many agents as you want. So in a typical distributed setup, you can have as many as, you know, 5, 10, even 20 different agents. However, in this demo, we will only be using one agent. However, you know, the process will be the same no matter how many agents that you have. So let's get started. The first thing you need to do is you should go to the Puppet module, Puppet project that you are going to use. So like I said before, we will be using Identity Server for this demo, and you should clone it in our Puppet environment. So my Puppet environment is located in etc Puppet code environments and production in production directory. So I will do a git clone command. All right. So the next thing we need to know is that our Puppet environment only needs these three directories, the manifests, modules, and scripts. Let's copy these directories into our Puppet environments from our clone project. So our clone project is here. Let's use the So we have copied these three directories into our Puppet environment. And what we have to do next is very simple and straightforward. If you want to try this out yourself, what you could do is you could go into any of our Puppet repositories and choose the product that you want to use. And you could follow the quick start guide in our documentation. So the first thing you should do is you should download a pack of the product that you are going to use, and then copy it into the modules, common, files, and packs directory. So since I already have one with me, so let me go into the modules, IS, common, files, and packs directory. I will copy my identifier file into this directory. So you can see I have copied my identifier pack into the files directory. Next, what you should do is you should copy a JDK distribution into your Puppet environment. So if you want to know the JDK distributions that we support, you can click the link here to find out these distributions. So in this demo, I will be using Amazon Corridor, but however you can feel free to use whatever that you are comfortable with. So what you should do is go to the JDK directory and copy your JDK into the JDK directory. All right, so that is all you have to do in terms of setting up your Puppet master. What you should do next is we should go into our Puppet agent and simply run the Puppet agent command. So the first thing we should do is, if you go into our documentation, is set a factor value to show which profile that you are running. So in our case, we will be running identity server and our profile is IS. So what you do is simply export it as a factor. And then all you have to do is run the Puppet agent. So this should take a few seconds. And once it's done, you will have a fully functioning setup of identity server running on your agent machine. Also, keep in mind, as I said before, you can have as many agents as you wish. If your distributed setup has as many as 20 different agents, you could set up any WSO2 products as a distributed deployment using a very few and simple Puppet commands. So that is it in terms of setting up and running WSO2 products using Puppet. Now let's get into why we are all here. Updates. How are we going to deliver updates to all these agents in a distributed setup? So as Vimukti explained earlier, we will be using something called the in-place updates tool to update the pack that we copied into our master's Puppet environment in the beginning. Actually, we do not need to worry about this tool at all. Instead, what you have to do is, we have provided script here, and we have provided this update script. And all you have to do is simply execute this script. Of course, if you want to learn more about this script, we have some documentation written, so you could always go back to this. So let's go into our scripts directory in the Puppet Master. So as you can see, we have the update script here. So if you run the update script, the help command, you can see how we should run this script is you should provide the script name, -p, and the profile that you are running, and this script will update your profile. So let's do that, shall we? And since we are updating our identity server profile, you just say IS. And it will ask if you have a WSO2 subscription. And you should say yes. Why? That is because you need a subscription to run updates on WSO2 products. If you do not have a subscription, you can sign up for a free trial. So give your subscription credentials here. And it will start updating your identity server back. So for those of you who were there for our previous session on running the in-place tool, you'll be familiar with what's happening here. So what it has done is it has taken a backup of our deployment, and it is running updates on top of what we already had. And it will say that package has been updated successfully, and it will repackage it with the completely updated package, updated product. There you go. So your setup of WSO2 identity server has now been updated. So how are we going to deliver these updates to all of our deployments? I'm pretty sure most of you would have guessed it by now already. So all you have to do is just go into the agent and run the Puppet agent command. And again, keep in mind that if you have multiple agents, all you have to do is run the Puppet agent command in all of those agents, and all of them will get updated. And as you can see, our updated product has now been deployed into the agent. And that is all that you have to do. It is as simple as that. So we have come to the end of our demonstration. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask us.
Okay, so we have a question on how frequently you update your Puppet resources. So we keep releasing Puppet modules in parallel with every product release, and we do release if there are improvements to our Puppet resources. And it is effortless to move on to the new version. So that's how frequently we update our Puppet resources.
All right, so we have another question. What if an update changes a file that has been templated? The update script that we showed earlier, what it does is it identifies that a templated file has been updated through the in-place updates tool. And you will be given a warning. You will be given a warning so that you can update the file according to the way that it has been updated.
Okay, there's another question. Can we use these modules in a lockdown environment? Yes. But you need internet to get updates. We recommend updating your deployments frequently. So what you can do is you can lock down the Puppet agents which is your deployment, and then let the Puppet Master have internet access. So at the moment, we are at the deployment stage of a new feature to our in-place updates tool, which is called offline updates, so that the user can get updates when they do not have internet access. So once these offline updates are introduced, we will improve our Puppet resources as well.
So we have another question. Is Hira comparable with your scripts? So as of right now, we are not using Hira in our setup. Although the way we have designed our modules, it is written in such a way that it can be made comparable with Hira.
Okay, so we have another question. Is it possible to customize these modules? Is there documentation around that? So let me go back in our slide deck. So this is our Puppet module architecture. As I explained in this profile module, we have this custom PP. So whatever the custom configurations or extensions you need to do to the Puppet resources provided by WSO2, you can add it here. And if you go to, if you need to expand or customize your Puppet resources for API Manager, so if you go to our GitHub and go to the README, you can see the documentation there, so that how to customize the given Puppet scripts. Another question, in the demo profile, setting as an export parameter, but in a production environment, what would be the WSO2 preferred way? So in a production environment, the default value is to get the whatever the changes in the Puppet Master in at a 30 minutes rate, but WSO2 create updates daily. So if you prefer to update your production environment daily, you can configure your Puppet agent to do that daily. But what we recommend is, if you get the updates at the Puppet Master, what we recommend is you can ship those updates first to your. Let me go to this next. So what we suggest is apply the updates to the dev environment first, and then test it out, and then ship to the staging environment, and then to the production environment. It would be better to ship the updates that way. So that's all the questions we got today. So these are the resources I talked about when I was presenting everything. So the first link is to WSO2 in-place updates. So you can go and read about WSO2 in-place updates, and also there are documents under updates about WAM as well. So you can go and read and understand more about WSO2 in-place updates and the WSO2 update story. The rest of the links are to WSO2 Puppet resources for all the products. So these four are the open source products. So if you want WSO2 Puppet resources for open banking, you have to create a subscription and you have to request the Puppet resources through your AIM. That's it for today. So thank you for joining our webinar. What we have next in our webinar series is webinar on continuous update delivery with Ansible. Please join us next Thursday. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.